We're going in. We're ready, and it doesn't even matter if we're ready, Dylan, because we're jumping in, dude. Because you are getting into this, and you are riding high. And it's another episode of We're All Psychos, and my name is Dylan Paladino, and this is my show, and this is the solo. This is the solo part of my show that I do every week, and then sometimes I do interviews. I'm gonna probably have one this week, and then other times I just do the solo one. Okay, and if you guys are like, well, I don't even know what this podcast is, because sometimes it's interviews and then sometimes it's you talking crazy. And hey, man, the only answer I have to that is yes. Okay. The only answer I have to that is, that's right. Because that's what I say when someone tries to put me in a box, dude. I've never wanted to be put in a box. No, there's no way. And when I go out and when I die, I am not getting put in a box, dude. I am either becoming ashes, I may be becoming a tree. There's that shit where they can put your body into like a tree pod, and then a tree grows out of you, which is like kind of poetic, but also grosses me out, kind of, even though, you know, you're dead and shit. You're just thinking about like, you're slowly decomposing. It's nasty. But yeah, I'd rather do that. Viking funeral, that's pretty sick. You go out on a boat and they light the boat on fire. That's pretty tight. I don't know, send me off a ski jump. Anything like that, but I ain't going out in a box. I am not going out like a okay. Pussyclot. I'm not going out like pussyclot. That. I'm not going out like a pussyclot. Straight up. And happy Sunday, guys. Happy New Year. Okay. How are you doing? If you're brand new, welcome to the show. All right, welcome to the empire. Welcome to my show. It's you know, it's what goes on in my head a lot, especially when I'm drinking coffee, and I'm just letting you guys into that world. Okay, I'm letting you into that. And if you're the person that I moved yesterday, and you said you were going to listen to my show, I mean, I'm not going to say her name, but I also think I forget it. Nope, I remember it. Do I? No, I forget it. I can look it up. But it's no offense to you. It's just because usually when I do something, I forget what happened almost immediately after. If you're listening, this is your first time. Hey, this is not going to be like Pod Save America. I know you told me you listened to Pod Save America and all of that crooked media stuff. And honestly, I think... Oh, my Whoop ran out of battery. Oh, I think Pod Save America... I think those guys are lame as fuck. And that's just because they are the kind of smart guys who like know they're smart and then they try to make jokes, but they're not good. And the undertone of every joke is I'm right. You know, and I don't like that. I don't like that. But I only listen to one episode, so I could be completely biased and just listen to a bad episode, which is probably what it is. But anyway, welcome if you're still listening. I'm happy you're still listening. I really am. How was your New Year's, guys? Was it weird? Was it weird like mine? Mine was weird. I think all of ours were, because we had to do something for New Year's because it felt kind of weird to just stay at home, even though some people did. I mean, most people stayed at home. I don't mean go out to a party. Like, maybe you saw a friend or two. I saw two friends. You know, we were all safe, as one can be. I think the main thing with being safe is not going to a giant party, which I don't think anyone was doing. But then I saw my friend sent me a video of fucking Miami, and people were like partying. Was it on Reddit? Reddit Miami New Year's. Like, dude, people were inside. Oh, this is just people asking for... I don't know how to use search apps, to be honest. I'm like, what are you... Where's my my friend group with all my friends? Liv Moss. That's what the friend group is called. My friend sent a video of it. People were just inside. Ah, here we go. A club in Miami, Florida. Let's put it onto the video so you guys can... Put it onto the screen so you guys can see it. I mean... And here's the problem with this video. Someone could have played this from a year ago. And, well, let's see if it has 2021 in it. 2021. Oh, never mind. He just said 2021. That's wild. I gotta stop saying that. That is so stupid. Let's be honest, man. Even if you want to party and you, whatever your thoughts are about the pandemic, that's the best way to spread it. And even if you're like, hey, it's overplayed, which I, you know, I'm not going to really, here's my opinion. Here's what I think about giving your thoughts about the pandemic publicly, like on something like this, or just in general. Most likely it's going to make you look dumb because we're going to figure out stuff later on. And even if someone comes out and tries to be like, well, here's how we could have done better. Here's how we're overplaying it. People talk about case fatality rates, shit like that. Da, da, da. Oh, it only kills whatever percent of the... We don't need to encourage people to be any more reckless than they already are. This is the reality. A lot of people aren't going to listen to any of the mandates or any of the suggestions. Well, they're not mandates. Any of the suggestions. Some of them are mandates that the government or health experts are giving anyway. Because people, number one, are selfish. They don't trust the government or other people. And, you know, I kind of get that. And at the end of the day, some people are just dumb also. That's a reality. So people are already not going to be listening. So to add to that and come out and give them any kind of ammo to back their point, I don't think is very responsible, right? You want to have a conversation with me about how it's been handled and how, you know, people are overblowing it some places. I will have that conversation with you because I think, I don't know, it's important to hear what other people are thinking. For first and foremost, so you can create an argument against that, or at least hold that argument in your head and try to find the cracks in it. Didn't someone once say like the sign of true intelligence is being able to hold two opposing arguments at once? Didn't someone say that? Sign of true intelligence, not illegal immigration. Intelligence, two arguments. I might have just made that up. F. Scott Fitzgerald. So, I mean, I don't know if you guys like that, but here's your D-Doc right here, dude. F. Scott Fitzgerald. The test of a first-rate intelligence is the ability to hold two opposed ideas in the mind at the same time and still retain the ability to function. Someone called that cognitive dissonance. We do that shit all the time. But yeah, you know, you hear him out and you go, okay, where'd you get that? Oh, why do you believe like that? It's just important to know what other people are thinking so you can understand more people. Because I think at the end of the day, understanding how other people think will allow you to be a better person and to function in the world more properly. Is there another word instead of saying more properly? Properlier is not a word. So just more properly. But you know what I'm saying? Here's the problem, dude. I say some fucking deep, profound shit like that, and then I also admit that I don't know better vocabulary. But that also makes me relatable because a lot of us don't have great vocabulary, and it shows that I admit to my weaknesses, right? Anyway, so don't know how I got there. Don't know how I got there. But so I went and hung out with a bunch of friends. We watched like the New Year's shows. They got to stop those, man. They have to stop. I mean, the fact that they did them during the pandemic when there was no audience, I don't know about you guys, that shit was so sad watching it. It was so sad because it reminded me about the pandemic and everything that's going on in the world. And then it also made me sad for these people's careers because I knew in the back of their heads, they're like, they were thinking, this is so sad. We're performing for three 21-year-old PAs and one AD who hates his life and cheats on his wife. Like, nothing is good. And, you know, all those people knew that they weren't the first choice for the New Year's Eve shows, but the other people the other higher up celebrities didn't want to do it, or the network didn't have the budget. So they called the C-rate celebrities to do it. And that sucks when you know that. And those celebrities do know that. And at the end of the day, they're still getting paid. They're happy about that. But man, I don't know about you guys, but I was watching it and it felt like they were overperforming to try and compensate for the fact that there was no audience and there was no energy. You know, there was one. I mean, the one on Fox had Ken Jeong and Joel McHale. I'm sorry. Who needs to see either of those guys? And no offense to them. I bet you they're both cool dudes. For real. I bet you they're both really cool dudes. I would love to talk to them. I'd love to have them on the show. And I bet you if I had them on the show, I'd be like, be honest, were you guys a little confused as to why you were there? And they'd go, yeah, I have no idea why I was hosting a New Year's Eve show. These, like, why are they there? And then they're trying to overdo it and be jokey. Dude, it was so strange. Craig Robinson was playing the piano. That was cool. But Carson Daly, who, by the way, his face got round, he was doing one of the shows. And they would just cut to live performances in studios with no audience, like with Gwen Stefani, who was horribly lip syncing. It sounded like I was watching her with the sound off, and then I had my AirPods in, and I turned them on, and they were 1 second delayed. And I still was like, hey, whatever, it looks close enough. I don't know why I would do that, but sometimes I'll watch a podcast on video, and then I'll put on my AirPods so I can hear it, and I'll sync it up. And that's just a little something about me. But I was watching it, and it was so uncomfortable and weird, and you knew they were performing for no one. It all just looked like tech rehearsals that they then had on New Year's, and then the ball dropped, and you're just like, no, nothing's gonna change. We hope it will, but let's be honest, it's still gonna be shitty for a while. I had fun though. This sounds like I didn't have fun. No, I did have fun because I set my expectations low, and I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be alive. I'm happy to be talking to you guys, and I'm happy with where my life is right now. I'll say I'm content. You know, I'm always pushing, but I'm content. But it was a very strange moment, I think, for all of us collectively to just be experiencing this, to be watching it. There's one thing to be watching it alone, but then the world is still going on as usual, right? Like, let's say for whatever reason you had to stay home, but then everyone was in Times Square. There were people out partying. I think it would be less sad because the world would still be going on. You'd still kind of be able to experience it vicariously by watching it. And yeah, you'd have some FOMO, but there probably wouldn't be a part of you that was like, I can't do this. But then when you're watching it and you know everyone else is at home watching it alone or with one or two other people, and then they're watching even the TV shows where everyone is almost alone, that is a strange, chilling feeling. Very, very chilling. To just know that everyone is collectively having this same feeling and thought, and no one's going to forget, no matter what happens. What did you do New Year's 2020? You'll know. You might not remember it fully because it wasn't that... It wasn't that crazy important that you experienced and like wrote down every moment in your long-term memory, but it's enough that you'll go, I was at home with these two people, or I did this. I don't know. Maybe some people went to an outdoor concert, and then there'll be the assholes that were in Miami that went to a party like that. And you know what? I'm jealous of them. I wish I could have done that. For like, withstanding everything that's going on, obviously. That's why you can't. But, you know, you see that and you're like, dude, you know why you get so mad at them? Because you're like, man, fuck you. I wish I could do that, but I'm being smart by not doing it. You know, but to each their own. If I met someone who did that, I would immediately be like, what was it like? Tell me about it. I wouldn't judge them. I try not to judge people over small acts and choices that they make. Try to judge them overall as to what they do. Everyone makes mistakes. Everyone has lapses in judgment. I've had them all the time. they happen to me almost every day. You do dumb things and you go, why did I do that? You know? But that's part of it. Anyway, it was strange. It was strange. And it was also indicative, here's what I wanted to say. It was indicative of how out of touch the people at the top are with just normal everyday people living their lives. Like the executives, the people that set up these shows. I could be wrong, but I only watched two of the channels. So maybe there were other channels with more people, more celebrities or people that we all cared about. The hosts for all the shows, I was like, why are they here? What these why are these old, like, no one cares about these people anymore at all. No one gives a fuck about them. Get someone new. Get younger people in here. And I don't even mean young, like someone who has to be 18. I just mean younger talent, new people, people that we are excited about. And not TikTok people, because those people kind of suck ass, even though I'm trying to get followers on it because that's what you got to do. But just new people, interesting people, man. Famous podcast, whatever, people, someone that the general public is listening to all the time, whether it's comedians, those are always good, but just hosts in general. There's so many, I can't think of anyone right now to, I mean, I guess the people you think about that you would want to do it probably wouldn't want to do it because they go, that would be lame, but maybe they would switch it up. Even the acts, even the musical acts, you were like, Gwen Stefani, what? Busta Rhymes. And don't get me wrong, both of them are great, but huh? That's not someone that you go, oh my God, I remember them. Wow, let's watch them perform for nobody. It's almost like a weird metaphor as to who cares about them, that they're performing for nobody. I don't know, get SZA, get I can't think of any. There's so many other performers that get. I'm in that weird mode where like I'm complaining about shit, but I can't think of specific artists, which is frustrating. I don't know. Get Lil Baby. I mean, don't get the baby. Lil Baby, don't get either of those. Migos, it'd be kind of fun. Any of those people. Someone new. Her. Just look at who, even at least SNL gets new acts that you're kind of like, oh, I haven't heard of this person. Let me check him out. Khalid. That's who I was thinking of. That's the guy who I was like, get Khalid, dude. He would have crushed it. I mean, maybe they're even, yeah. And the reason why it's indicative about, or why it's exemplative, if that's a word, as to how people are completely out of touch, is just like how the musical acts and the people hosting were celebrities and people we don't care about. Everyone in office who's in charge right now are these old fucks that shouldn't be in charge. And most of them are old white dudes, but that doesn't matter. It's just about being old fucks. Nancy Pelosi's too fucking old. Get out. Chuck Schumer, get the fuck out. Mitch McConnell, I'm sorry, kill yourself, dude. For real. For real, dude. You suck ass. And that's not even on either side of the political spectrum to say that. I think even most Republicans can admit that Mitch McConnell sucks horse dick, man. He sucks it poorly to where the horse is like, I can't even stay hard. You know, that's how bad it is. That dude sucks, man. He sucks. He's the kind of guy that when you're at dinner, like if he was in your family and you were at dinner with him, like Thanksgiving dinner, he would just say some shit to immediately make you feel bad. He would all the time treat his wife like shit, would be drinking with two other guys, What? That's the guy. That guy never helps with the dishes. Mitch McConnell never helps with the dishes. He never helps set up. He brings a present that is shitty from like Walmart or something that he got on the way. Or you know what? Even if he brings some nice alcohol, he brings a present and then he keeps talking about it the entire time and wants to make sure everyone knows that he brought it and he puts it out there so everyone can see. And then he opens it while he's there. He brings like a $200 scotch, says, here you go. And then he opens that shit and starts drinking it after he gave it to you. That's the kind of dude Mitch McConnell is. You know what? He's the kind of dude that when the service is just okay, he tips 12% and he calculates it out and he pulls out an old ass calculator. You know those old calculators that have the little like they're flat and then they have the little like angle up? You know those old ones that people used to that shit hit the clear button, that kind of shit. He carries one of those around with him and he tips people like that. 12%. That's it. Even though this dude is so much money, he tips 12% if the meal wasn't perfect. Motherfucker eats chicken breast with no salt and pepper. Just straight up chicken breast. Cooked. Overcooked. Nothing on it. Nothing on it. Maybe some ketchup on the side. You sick fuck! Ew! Ew, Mitch McConnell. Ew, MM. Your name, your initials sound cool, but you're not cool. Get your fucking neck fixed, bro. Get your neck fixed. Go onto an island and live out the rest of your years. Stop ruining people's lives. That's how he sounds. And that's not even a caricature of what he sounds like. He actually sounds. His neck. We gotta look this motherfucker up. I'm sorry, dude. And you know what? If you like him, or you like his policies, I can maybe understand that. But you gotta admit, dude, all this is still fucking funny and true. He sucks as a person. Come on, Mitch McConnell. Hands? Does he have weird hands? No, he's normal hands. He just looks. I mean, people get him at bad angles, but this dude looks bad. Does he have weird hands? Oh, what happened? Oh, he's got a bunch of band-aids on his hands and shit. Oh, the fuck? That's his hand? There's no way his hand looks like that. His hands were discolored? Wait, we got to research this more. I saw on BuzzFeed, so it's probably bullshit. There's no way that's him. He's 78. When was this written? Oh, this was written 2 months ago. That's fine. He's 78. Get all these motherfuckers that are over 65 out of the government. They're out of touch, man. They don't understand. They legit have no idea. They don't even understand what it's like. And don't worry, guys, the second half of the show, I'm going to talk about some stupid shit. I'm sorry, but I'm just going off on a rant, and this is what it is, okay? And I'm also not sorry because you guys are like, I'm loving this. You guys are just like, you guys are fucking, no, get the sound drop. You guys are just like, that's what you guys are like now. You're like, yeah, that's what you're like. That's what you're like. When Dylan talks about politics, yeah. And then me at the end of this, I'm just going to be like,
I'm just saying,
you know? Anyway, so on Wednesday, photo on vial, picking up it. Okay, so it is. Those are his hands. Bro, his hands are like a different color. But I'm serious. Is there anything going on we should know? Of course not. Weird. Strange. Then he got elected again. He puts his hands in his pockets. Smart man, not right there. Can we see him talking? Like I have a producer saying, hey, Jordan, can we see him talking? It'd be cool if my producer's name was Jordan. Anyway, Mitch McConnell speaking. This is 2 years ago.
With an amendment.
Let's hear this. Majority Leader.
Colleagues, here's where we are.
Our car is here.
It's now clear there are enough votes to proceed to the pending legislation on government funding, disaster relief, and border security.
I mean, dude, his voice is what I...
Now, Congressman, here's where we are. It's saying now that we can go forward on border security. Please.
Dude, his voice sounds like an evil old plantation owner. And I'm not even trying to make this like that. Like, you know, that's so stereotypical to like, oh, old white guy who's Southern, make him a plantation owner. I know. But for real, it's his voice. That was 2 years ago. Let's see what it looks like now.
The two things that were the most contentious and agree on all the rest.
Bro, his lips don't move.
It is still my hope we're going to get an omnibus.
wait. That's pretty funny.
Get an omnibus appropriation.
That's a noise he makes during sex. This, all the rest. Right here.
So it is still my hope we're going to get a...
That.
I just don't agree on all the rest. So it is still my hope we're going to get a an omnibus appropriation.
Omnibus appropriation.
Have attached to it when it comes over from my house. An agreement
house.
That we've been able to reach with the four corners and Secretary Mnuchin and the president.
Bro, look at him from the side. He has no chin. His chin goes right down to his giblet. And that he has a giblet, like a turkey. Nothing. He just sucks, man. What did he look like when he was younger? Mitch McConnell. Like, I want to see like, if you could tell what he was going to... Yeah, he always sucked, man. I'm not kidding. Like... You look at him, and his neck really dropped. This is him really young. He still looks kind of like a piece of shit. But there was hope there. There's potential for him to be a normal, nice person, not... Why is there a picture of AOC next to Mitch McConnell? This is why everyone... This is another reason why people like AOC, honestly. Regardless of her policies, is that... Dude, she gets it. In the terms of, like, she just gets how most people live their lives just in terms of using a phone, dude. Mitch McConnell doesn't have any idea how any of that shit works. At least AOC is like, I get it. I grew up with the internet. I grew up using phones. I understand how things work. She definitely speaks much better than I do. She's also definitely evil because anyone that wants to be a politician is evil. Besides maybe Andrew Yang. But she gets it. All these old fuckers, man, get out. And that's it. That's all I have to say. That's enough. You guys, you know, politics is not for the show, dude. I'm done. I'm done with that. I'm done. But you get it. And I hope I voiced some feelings and some sentiments that you had. And I hope when I started talking about politics that you guys... I fucking lost the soundboard. I hope when I started talking about politics, you guys were not like this, and it's taking too long to load, so the timing's all off. It's not gonna be funny anymore, but I hope when I was talking about politics, you guys weren't like,
"Then fuck."
I hope you guys weren't like that. It's okay. I smoked some...
Smoking big doinks and Amish.
Last night, I was doing that. Getting high as shit with a friend. But now it's New Year, man. It's 2021, and that's how we're living now. Oh, fuck, I haven't been recording any of this. That sucks ass. I just realized that live. New screen recording. Well, what's nice is that nothing I brought up on screen is that important. So I ain't going to insert it. But from now on, there's going to be shit on. And guys, that's a backwards look into how this show operates, is that I really, on air, just realized I hadn't been recording the screen at all. Yeah, so I was like this.
And fuck.
That's what I was just like right now. I was just being a straight up...
pussy clut!
That's what I was being. Bitch. Bitch ass. Anyway. Drove up. I worked with this guy this week for the moving company. I drove up and... Yeah, it's crazy to me how some people eat. We went to a gas station. This guy goes and he gets, really nice guy, by the way, really nice guy, a simple man, if you get what I'm saying, just a simple guy. And we go, and he gets gas station nachos and Reese's and starts eating them when we're about to move someone. I don't know how he's alive. And this is the kind of guy that will live until he's 110. And they'll be like, what's your secret? And he'll be like, just enjoying every day, man. You just wake up and you enjoy every day you live. That's what it is. And you go, yeah, well, I'm not going to live that. There's no way I live as old as you because I'm too worried about what I'm eating. There's way too much shit I'm worrying about to try to live longer. And your ass is just eating fake cheese and Reese's and playing the PSP. And you're still, PSP, is that even around anymore? And you're still going to live longer than me. There are those people in life that they just truly don't care. And they just live how they want to. And they're freaks. They're outliers. And they live longer than all of us. And I'm jealous of them. That shit, it's impressive. No cares. No cares, this guy. I worked with him once. He told me he hit his toe the night before when he went to go pee. And it was hurting. And I remember I was like, well, maybe you know, he shouldn't be at work. I'll go get it checked out. Maybe rest it a couple of days. He tells me when I worked with him. He's like, yeah, I went to the hospital after because it was throbbing when I was going to sleep. Turns out I fractured it and I dislocated it. And I'm like, dude, why didn't you leave work immediately? He's like, yeah, no, it was fine. I went home. Trooper. Those are the real superheroes, man. Those. No cape. Instead, he wears a Echo hoodie. That's what he wears. Those are the real superheroes. That guy. Sorry to flex on you guys, but I just had to scratch my shoulder. Oh, man. My abs are fucking huge. Oh, really serious first part of the podcast, but it's okay. It's okay. I'm happy to be here with you guys. Let's go through some saved videos I have on my phone. We got some Russian videos for sure. What else did I write down? Let's see what else I wrote down on the... Talk about being a wingman. Still not going to talk about that. Because it hasn't come up. It'll come up. It'll come up. It'll come correct. Did you guys hear about how John McAfee... How do you say his name? McAfee? John McAfee? John McAfee? Does it have the IPA? McAfee. Oh, no, it's McAfee. McAfee. John McAfee. Born September 18th, 1945, is an English-American computer programmer and businessman. He founded the software company McAfee Associates in 1997 and ran it until 1994 when he resigned from the company. So I think there's already some kind of controversy with him. He ran for president in 2016 for the Cyber Party. What an idiot. Oh, and then he ran in 2020. McAfee has contended that taxes are illegal and has claimed in 2019 that he had not filed a tax return since 2010. And he refers to himself as a prime target for the U.S. IRS. Okay, now here's the cool thing. So, in 2007, this dude wrote on Twitter, he predicts the price of one Bitcoin will be $500,000. The price of one Bitcoin would jump to $500,000 within 3 years. And if not, I will eat my own dick on national television. This is true. And he doubled down like every... John McAfee. He doubled down like every year. This guy. Fucking still has to John McAfee still has to eat his own dick on live television. Bitcoin's low of 1,800 yesterday simply could not be maintained. Long term, Bitcoin moves about 500,000 within 3 years. Bets. And then under it, he wrote, if not, I will eat my own dick on national television, which he said, if not, I will eat my dick on national television, which is a hilarious thing to say. And of course, no one actually thought he was going to do it. But so funny to say. And people start following, right? 3 years later, Bitcoin's at $9,000. So got a long way to go. It actually jumped pretty significantly recently, but it's $25,000. And then all these people are posting tweets on like, oh, time's up, John McAfee. And then he responds. He goes, why would I care about someone's post? The bet was the end of 2020. And end of 2020. And then he tweets again. It's well documented that I will eat my dick on December 31st, 2020, not July. Well, will I eat it? You bet. Myself or perhaps a subcontractor. Doesn't make any sense. And then this dude. And then again, when I predicted Bitcoin at $500,000 by the end of 2020, it used it as a model that predicted $5,000 at the end of 2017. Bitcoin has accelerated much faster than my model assumptions. I now predict Bitcoin at $1 million by the end of 2020. I will still eat my dick if wrong. He tweeted this November 2017. He did all this stuff. And then this motherfucker came out and was like, of course I'm not eating my dick. It was just a ruse to get people to onboard and start using Bitcoin. And you know what? I hope he fucking dies by something biting his dick off. That's the kind of justice, that's the kind of poetic justice that we deserve. John McAfee, I'm sorry, but you set yourself up for it, bro. I think he also has things with like prostitutes and shitting on him, right? Is an antivirus fugitive. He has guns too. I mean, this guy's insane. We could go a whole episode on this guy. I haven't done enough research on. He lives with a bunch of. Okay, wait. You guys need to see this. I need to bring this on the screen. He lives with a bunch of prostitutes and just carries around guns. Whoa, what the hell? So he just lives with all these. Bro, what a weirdo. I thought I would do a brief introduction to the girls who live with me. He's like a super villain. Insane. Truly insane. I have all the girls hang out together. Easier to keep tabs on someone's actions if other girls were watching. All the girls told me about their secrets. I mean, this is from the Daily Mail, but still. Eating women's shit? John McAfee, my favorite part was eating women's shit. Wait, what is this? This is him. Scat, is that Showtime's claim? That explains it. I'm in high demand because of my kinks. I invented self-fraud, for example, and experienced an unexplained recent uptick. No wonder women were pissed when I asked to sacrifice a child while... Okay, so this guy's just a straight-up troll. So he's just a troll. But because of that, I mean, he doesn't seem like a good dude. I know he created the antivirus software, but no one even uses that anymore. Yeah, he should die by having his fucking dick eaten. Oh, yeah, the John McAfee hammock thing. This is it.
Sit on this hammock. The hammock has a hole.
He puts in a hammock. Then after that, he lies on another hammock. Then he,
you know, he would cut a little hole and he would sit there. That's what he used it for. Because he wanted to have, like, Scott sex, and I didn't agree with that.
What is Scott sex?
And when you
I hate that. I know what she's doing. She has to have it explained, but it's like
poop in someone's mouth.
You know.
He used to make you shit in his mouth. Like that.
This girl's awesome, dude. This girl's fucking awesome. She definitely did it and thought it was funny and just disrespected him.
I've never had done that before, and it was an experience for me.
He puts his head under your butt and he asks you to shit in his mouth.
Did he ever have regular intercourse, like vaginal intercourse?
No.
What?
That was the only thing I did.
She just... Oh, this is why she's so happy. She's like, I just made a bunch of money just shitting on a guy's mouth.
Because I wanted to finish school.
Wow. The shit that... The shit, honestly, that people will do to be turned on like that is... I almost said wild, but I didn't. It's crazy. It's over the edge. It's... honestly, too much. And we can agree on that. But John McAfee's got to eat his own dick, dude. This motherfucker lied. He lied. He deserves to have his dick eaten off, bit off. Let's look at some Russian videos. Okay, so this one is set the scene. We're in a gas station. Okay, there's a bunch of people in line. This one guy, second from the back in line, is very drunk. And the guy behind him is not having it. So he just starts slamming him into a vending machine. Slamming him. Continuously slamming. He's like, stop. Oh, and this girl starts beating the shit out of this guy. It's awesome. She kicks him in the nuts. Two shots in the face. Oh, and then she decks his ass, dude. She decks his ass. And fucking good for her, bro. She lays him out. And the drunk guy walks up and is like, thank you so much. And she's like, also get the fuck out of my store. She does shake his hand, though. She's like, he's just drunk. That's what all these other guys cut in line in front of the other dude. That's the most disrespectful shit ever. This guy got knocked out and the other people walk up and like, okay, well, we're getting in line because your ass is on the ground. Let me try and give his subtitles. This is crazy. Get out of my way, bro. Get out of my way. You know, I'm gonna knock you out. Get your stupid head out of here. Just stupid jacket. Hey, stop hitting him. What's wrong with you? Oh, you dumb. Oh, I'm gonna fuck you up. Do something again. I'll knock your ass out. He goes, do it, bitch. I dare you. Boom! Knocks his ass out. Let's go. She goes, stupid pussy ass bitch. Small ass dick bitch. All right? I bet you my clit's bigger than your dick. That's what she said. That's what she said. And those other guys walked by. Pussy. You're a pussy. He goes, give me, you dap me up. He goes, stop being out of balance. What do I have to do? Let me knock your head until it works more. So he hits it. This other girl goes, that's my brother-in-law, you stupid fuck. Get your dumb hat off. I'll slap the fuck out of you. I dare you, cunt. Oh! Don't call me that. Only my grandma can call me that. Hey, give me daps. Give me daps right now. Yeah, that's right. I'm a gangster motherfucker. That's right. Hell yeah. Hey, you know what? Give me daps one more time. Hell yeah, bitch. We don't fuck around. That's right. That's awesome. Guy doing? This guy trying to start a fire and then he lights himself on fire, right? So this guy's pouring a full tank of gas into, and now he's on fire. He's in a fire pit. It's everywhere. I don't know why he thought that was smart. This is in the backyard because you get those old plastic chairs. He's like, come on, get vodka. I forget what happens. Oh, the guy jump. Oh, I completely forgot about this. He tried to jump into a pool and then more gasoline goes everywhere. Where is he? He gets caught on fire again. What an idiot. Honestly, the backtrack is pretty tight. This dumbass. And that's Russia for you. He's trying to, he broke the pool and there's water just going everywhere. What is, and the fire's still going. What is happening? Oh my God. He's like, okay, start the fire up. There's a tiny bit of fire in there. Let's just pour all this diesel fuel in there. Okay, yeah. Oh yeah, okay, it's all over me. Oh shit. The guy's honestly so calm, by the way. He doesn't scream. Neither of them are screaming. Oh shit. Oh no, there's fire. What do we do? Oh, let's go to... He's like, oh, get the pool, get the pool. Get the pool right over there. Conveniently, we have a pool. Oh, I'm completely on fire. Oh shit, he tries to throw the... Oh, that's what it is. The can of gasoline is... He was trying to throw it into the fire. Which I don't think would work because the gas will just go to the top. And then said he drops it. He's still on fire. Now all the grass is on fire. I mean, the background music is so funny. It's like the backtrack to when someone starts rapping, or you know what it is? It's a backtrack to when someone's getting yoked in the gym, and instead it's this guy potentially burning down his house. He jumps in the water. He tries to get the gas can. Can't get it. It's too hot. Now he gets it, throws it in. Doesn't work. Jumps in the pool again with the water. Is trying to... tries to break the pool, except the water doesn't go to where he wants it to. It goes everywhere. The fire's still raging. Completely flooded the car now. There's dumb people in Russia and America. That's good. Let's watch this one. I haven't seen this one. It's some lady pulling a bench into... You can't pull your bench into here. Yes, I can. Where am I going to sit? You sit on the regular seats. No. This bench is more comfortable. Do people here think I can have a bench or not? No one answers. You're not pulling this bench in here. Also, you're way too weak. You're not getting it in. Okay, you know what? Fuck you. That's it. You cannot pull a bench in here. Listen to me. Look at my mink coat. What the fuck is wrong with you? Who raised you? Who's going to help me with this bench? Come on. No one's going to help you with the bench. Get the hell out of the bus. Amazing. Oh, here's the translation. Translation, get out, woman. Look me in the eyes. Are you insane? We're not going anywhere. I'm going to call the police. This is my territory. Wow, I love this. This is so good. I love the men sitting quietly in the corner. This is fairly polite for Russian standards. I'm Russian and I can translate, but it's not what you think. You think they're arguing about bringing the bench onto the bus. Nope. They're arguing about whether Bitcoin will continue to dominate cryptocurrency world or if Ethereum will. Very confusing. Well, this is great. This is so good. I will beat you with this bench, you Sasquatch-looking bitch. Wow, I hope she said that. And this crazy other woman is like, please close the door, the bus is getting cold. Wow. I mean, wow. What else did I have on this? Talked about John McAfee. It was okay. Could have been better. What are you going to do? I just saw a video about Gordon Ramsay having a blind chef on the show. He's just yelling at this woman, the chef, who's blind. Which, you know what, I don't respect it, but also, like, this blind woman comes in the show. She just wants to be treated like a chef. Gordon Ramsay goes, I'm not going to give you any special treatment. And he shouldn't. But also, she should have a helper, dude. I'm going to be honest, because she's, like, trying to find the ingredients. And... Was it on MasterChef? Yeah. Blind Chef Gordon Ramsay. Was this recently? This must have been recent. This is a commercial for Whoop. Already got mine on, even though I forgot to charge it. Oh, this must have been MasterChef Season 10.
Ramsay is getting served karma. Are you really blind?
Yes, chef, I am.
Gee, you cause a stir out there, literally.
Yeah, I didn't mean it, actually.
Some hot water for celebrity chef facing some payback.
Everyone thought.
Are you, I mean, is it, are you really blind? Is that what they're mad at him for? I mean, yeah, I guess that's kind of fucked up to ask someone, but.
How is this girl going to cook blind?
You're going to be judged like everybody else in this competition.
Yes, chef.
Reggie! Come here, stop that. What was serving? Get a grip and wake up.
Hell yeah.
Kind of a gives a live crab to the blind chick,
a guy that's treating her like a regular person.
Let's give it to her.
No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Actually, I'm gonna be honest, this is all cut together, so I have no idea what happened. Maybe this guy up here is a huge dick and shouldn't have done it.
I'm freaking out for her.
It pierced me.
She's like very easily flustered. What the hell?
Oh, this guy kind of seems like
a cock.
Honestly,
chef, there's just no excuse. I was flustered.
A dream, she says, that turned into a real kitchen.
Yeah, but she owns it.
Actually, no. There can only be one.
She wins? At this point, so she walks up, right? She's blind. She walks up with a helper. At this point, the producers are just fucking with him. When he's like, oh, shit. They got a blind lady on the show, and now I'm going to have to be my, because the show also MasterChef, like he's kind of, his thing is him being an asshole to people. So now he's like, are you kidding me, dude? I got to be an asshole to this person. Come on, man. That's what this face is. He's like, seriously? This right here. Oh, you got to be fucking kidding me. I'm going to get in so much trouble for this. That's what he's thinking right now. And he's also like, I'm going to light her up. Those are the two thoughts going on in his head at the exact same time. The evil and the trying to take care of his career part. I'm going to light her ass up. Damn, there are going to be so many good scenes of me being a shithead to this blind lady. And the also other side is like, wow, they really set me up for this. This is fucked. I'm going to get in an argument with one of my producers. So she starts cooking. And
I'm blind.
No, chef. When I was maybe about 10 years ago, I was diagnosed with a... I'm sorry, can you tell me where I had put the green onion?
The green onion?
Still in the bowl?
It should be right in front of you.
It's right in front of me?
Right in front of your hand.
This is fucked up, dude. Okay. This is fucking... This is actually making me mad. You want to know why? Because they're setting this woman up to, like, look... To look... like... unable and weak's not the right word, but disadvantaged. And I bet you she knows how to cook great. The only thing is she can't fucking see. So she should have a helper to just tell her where the shit is. If she did, if she could be having this entire conversation with the chefs and at the same time have like a service, literally just a sous chef, dude. Normal chefs have that. Just have a sous chef that's like, hey, here's the green onion. She's like, oh, where's the green onion? The guy adds it or hands it to her. Because what else do you expect? Her to just feel it all out? That just takes way too much time. But instead, they set this. I bet you even if they asked her, hey, do you want someone just to tell you where the stuff is so you can be busy making the actual food and talking to the chefs? She'd be like, yeah, of course. That'll make it a lot easier. And the thing is, it's not treating her any differently because she has a disability, which is not being able to fucking see. So, just like everyone else who can't see, she should have something that allows her to see, or at least to know where the things are, the ingredients are. Because at the end of the day, even if she knows where the ingredients are, it's still fucking harder for her to put everything together and see it and go off by that. So she's already doing something harder than most of the other chefs. And then now to set her up like this, this is just that TV shit that pisses me off. Because then they play this music, they show her not being able to cut the onion well.
Around the same time that I started teaching myself how to cook. But every time my vision would decrease, I would have to teach myself again, how do I use
the
stove,
make it a story.
How do I use a knife.
It's just...
My mother was very overprotective of me, and she didn't let me help her in the kitchen at all. She would tell me to stay away from the sharp knives or get away from the hot stove, I didn't learn to cook with her.
I was often embarrassed of the foods that my mom used to pack for me to take to school. Everyone was disgusted that it was smelly.
But I regret to this day never having learned to cook from her.
Oh.
My mother actually died when I was 14.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And all of a sudden, part of my childhood was gone.
Okay, so that's why they cast this girl. They're like, okay, sob story. Mom died. She never learned how to cook. Then she became blind while she was learning how to cook. And now we're going to put her on a show with a guy who is known for abusing the contestants on the show. It's ratings. That's what that is. It's manipulative, dude. It's using it. It's fucking bullshit, honestly.
I love the fact that you're tasting everything.
I have to. I can't see.
Just to taste everything.
I really love cooking, cool, actually. But I thought it was going to be something I would have to give up. What it's gonna not taste being like. Able to. I'm just thinking, like, how am I ever going to cook for myself?
Vietnamese.
The dish does need the sort of stability. It's a staple done beautifully, but missing the rice.
Yes, chef. I understand. I'm sorry.
You know, you're going to be judged like everybody else in this competition.
Yes, chef.
In the history of MasterChef, we've never had a blind contestant. Your personal challenge is size. For me, that's one of the most delicious dishes I've tasted in this competition so far.
Oh, what?
Do you know what I'm going to give you?
A white apron.
A white apron. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Christine's the most amazing woman I think I've ever seen in my entire life. She just amazes me at what she can do.
Wait, what the?
It's delicious.
Oh, thank you, chef.
It's fresh. It's fragrant. You cook every freaking time like an angel. Good job.
Thank you.
Seriously.
I've never seen Christine do anything that isn't perfect.
You should be incredibly proud.
Well, okay, I'm so confused as to what's going on. The other clip made it seem like he was being an asshole to her. And then now it's like he's praising her and she's killing it on the show. This is what's so annoying about everyone sharing these clips now is that it's just misrepresenting what the show was. Like,
I really have mad respect for that lady.
You exceeded our expectations.
Did she win?
As you know, there can only be one winner.
Oh, does she win? Tell me that she fucking winner. Wins.
Christine!
Yeah, yo. The guy, it's her and this one black dude up there. And he's like, you can see on his face, he's like, I know it's Christine. There's no way they couldn't give it to the blind chick. I'm sorry. The blind chick whose white whose mom is dead and she never learned how to cook. She had to teach it to herself as she started to go blind. And you're gonna give it to someone else? No shot.
Christine!
Wait. So, number one of court. Wow, he's so big. Or maybe she's really short. No, she's really short.
When I cook, I feel like my mom's spirit is somewhere nearby.
Oh, yeah, of course. They have to say some fucking corny shit like that.
If my mom were still here today, I would ask her to teach me how to make her Vietnamese beef noodle soup. Although each time I make it, it gets better and better. It has yet to still capture the
this
memory
background
of
music is so corny. I'm probably gonna get
I
taken off of
all of these things.
No, this is on YouTube.
A tribute to her.
You know what's crazy is that I played something on this show from YouTube, two clips from YouTube, and then they removed my show because they said it was breaking their guidelines. And I'm like, I played videos from your own website. So this is annoying that. That other clip, what I got shown, the only whole reason why I watched this, the whole reason why we brought this up was because I got shown a clip where Gordon Ramsay was being shitty to some blind chick on the show. And everyone was like, I can't believe he's doing that, blah, blah, blah. And I was trying to be like, well, you know, he's going to treat her just like everyone else, which it seems like he did. And then we realized that was like two clips. He was nice to her. She ends up winning, probably because she made some bomb food, but also because she's blind. And that was completely misrepresentative of what the show is. Dis, or is dis representative a word? Because dis means you're doing it to disrepresent. No. No, it's just misrepresent. It's just misrepresent. Whatever. I tried. But, dude, that's so annoying. I hate... And I bet you that moment where he goes, are you really blind? I bet you it was supposed to be a compliment because she made something that was so bomb that he didn't believe that she was blind. Like as a joke. And they're like, hey, he's in hot water for asking if she's Gordon Ramsay in hot water for asking a blind woman if she's really blind on live television. Even though we all know that it was probably set up and they had multiple camera angles of it. And after it, he apologized to her and was like, you know, it was just a joke, right, love? That's what really happened. But anyway, because there's nothing really going on and we like to stir up controversy for no reason, we're going to talk about it for 30 minutes. We're going to have contestants on the show that lost and didn't like Ramsay because he shit on their bad dishes talk about how he's really not a good guy. Tonight at 8:30. That's what it is. And remember last week when I was talking shit about the news? Came full circle. One of the girls was listening to the show and she was like, you were talking about how the news, like doing that conspiracy theory about the news and how they just like want to pit us together and just bring up all this fake news. And I thought you were sounding like Alex Jones. And then you called yourself out for sounding like Alex Jones. And you know what? That's what I do, baby. Know thyself. I know what I sound like, and I call it out before you guys can. Hell yeah, dude. Defense mechanism. All right. Love you all. Thank you all for listening to the show. Have a good rest of your Sunday. We will talk to you soon. Have a good week, psychos. Later.